So welcome. In this video, let us look at the question number 41 to 50. Now, the question number 41 says a CPU can process data at the speed of. Actually, this question is completely wrong. They should not ask this kind of questions in the examination because it totally depends on the CPU architecture and totally depends on the kind of instruction that they are executing. So I should say the answer is none of the above, but I don't know, they have given some exact values. So as I've seen the in the solution videos and in the solution that they have already given, so they are saying 5 nanosecond as the answer, but I don't know, 5 nanosecond should not be the answer. So I can say this question is not properly formulated. Now let us look at the question number 42. 42 says in random access memory data transfer is. So in random access memory, this is also called as RAM. So in case of RAMs, you can transfer data from main memory to the random access memory or from random access memory to the main memory, as well as from random access memory or RAM to CPU or CPU to RAM. So this random access memory is bidirectional. It is not unidirectional. It is not simplest transfer. It is bidirectional. Now question number 43 says the memory capacity in the computer system is normally not stated as, not stated. See, memory capacity is not stated as this KB because this is saying it is kilobit. So when I'm saying capital B, capital means it is byte. So we say that memory capacity is given in kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, but it is never given in kilobit. So the answer is option number B. Now let us look at this question. They are saying which is the only flash memory that we have. So here, out of this RAM, PROM, EPROM, we have only EEPROM as the only flash memory. Now question number 45 says SIMM is. So SIMM is serial in memory module. So this is the correct answer, others are the wrong answer. Right, now for question number 46, which is not a primary memory. So out of these memories, L1 cache is not a primary memory, L2 cache is not a primary memory, magnetic tape is not a primary memory, we have the main memory. Main memory means it is the RAM is the primary memory. Magnetic tape means it is the hard disk or secondary storage. This is also called as secondary storage. So primary memory is the main memory, or you can say the RAM. Now let us look at these questions. So question number 47 says that which memory has the highest capacity. So as I've told you many times, we have discussed this question many times, that hard disk is having the highest capacity as compared to the other memories. Cache memory is very small, main memory is greater than the cache memory, and the CD-ROM is actually, it is a secondary memory, but its capacity is not very very high. So CD-ROM nowadays, they are storing somewhere around 700 MBs of data, but main memory itself, for example on my laptop, I have 16 GBs of main memory. So generally we are using 8 GB to 24 GBs as the general purpose computers as a main memory. Now for question number 48, they are saying the device that provides backup storage is called. Which is the device that provides backup storage? Now for this particular case, main memory is not providing backup storage because it is volatile. That means as soon as you turn off your computer, your memory will be erased. Now cache memory is also volatile. Virtual memory is not used to store the data. Virtual memory is a concept of that is used in operating system to execute the programs, or that is also, you need to understand the concept of paging to understand the virtual memory also. So virtual memory is not used to store the data. So here the answer is option number C, that is auxiliary memory. Now question number 49 says the static RAM consists of. Now here the static RAM consists of the internal flip-flop. So this is the correct answer for this given problem. Now this is not large access time because obviously RAMs are very very fast, and internal capacitors I cannot say. So here internal flip-flops are there in the static RAM, or it is also called as SRAM. Static RAM is also called as SRAM. So you can just read about SRAM and you'll see that SRAM is made up of flip-flops. Now in the question number 50, they are saying the RAM 128x8 chip has. So generally, again in this problem, they have made printing or typing mistakes. So they should have written 128k cross. Okay, it is correct. Sorry, 128k cross 8 and 128 cross 8, both are different things. So when I'm saying 128 means these are the number of cells we have. In every cell, these are the number of bits. That means your main memory is divided into 128 cells, and in every cell we are storing 8 bit of information. So because we are having 128 cells, now to represent the address of each cell, we require how many bits that you can identify. That is 128 can be written as 2^7. So log 128, which is actually 7 bits. So we require 7 bit of information to represent the addresses, right? So when we say 128K, 128K means it is 128 into 2^10, right? So it is 2^17 cells. So because they are saying only 128 cells, so we can have 7 bits to represent the address. Therefore, address lines are of 7, or you can say we are going to have 7 address lines. So straight away, option number A and option number C are wrong. Now, because we have 8 bit of information, therefore we are going to have 8 data lines. So option number B is the correct answer. Option number D is also a wrong answer for this given question. Now let us look at the question number 51 to question number 60.